Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about one of the important wireless concept, that is wireless body area network. We are also going to discuss the various applications of the same technology. So let's begin with the topic. Network is basically formed when two or more than two computers get connected with each other in order to perform certain tasks. The task may be a sharing of resources, or it may be a file exchange, or it may be a normal electronic communication. So when two or more than two computers get connected with each other, they forms a network, and that connection is either a wired or wireless connection. Before evolution of wireless connection, the computer network is formed by using either a wired cable or by using a optical fiber cable or any other form of cable. But there are certain limitations of wired communication. It is not possible to provide a wired communication in the area where the restriction of the place is more. So in that case, the communication is achieved by using a wireless medium. So basically, in case of wireless medium, instead of using wired for transmission and reception of data, the air interface, or we can say a radio signals, are used for the medium of transmission. Now in this topic, we are going to talk about specifically a wireless body area network. Now let's start with it. In modern technology, wireless communication provides a lot of possibilities, and because of which it is possible for the user to share their information or to have a communication with each other at any place and from anywhere and at any moment of time. Intelligent mobile communication network and the wireless LAN, Wi-Fi are applied to the various sectors. That means we can use a wireless network in the form of wireless LAN or in the form of Wi-Fi in the various sectors, which includes a medical and healthcare sector, it includes the industrial sector, as well as it includes the education sector also. So in all this area, the wireless communication plays an important role. It basically provides a convenient way for the people to have a communication or to have a data exchange with each other. Basically, the main aim of data exchange is to share the ideas or to share the information so that the information can be transmitted or it can get spread all over the world. We can use air or radio interface as a medium of communication. As the demand of ubiquitous network is increased, the devices for home, offices, and other information devices that can communicate wireless in short range have been getting more attraction and more attention. Definitely, as the technology is growing, the demand of the user as well as the demand of ubiquitous networking is get increases. And because of that, the devices which provides a wireless communication to the user, that means the device which allows the user to have a mobility get increases. The standard and techniques development of ubiquitous network has rapidly put itself into the world market. Wireless body area network is becoming a special application of such technique. So we can say that the wireless body area network allows the user to move anywhere without having a restriction of the cable. And because of that, it is considered as one of the important applications in the area of medical and health sector. So let's start with the introduction of wireless body area network. So wireless body area network, which is also called as wireless body area sensor network, and it is represented as WBAN or WBASN, that is wireless body area sensor network. Basically, it consists of the sensor nodes which are attached in and around of human body for detecting the biosignals of the human being. That biosignals can be used in the variety of application, especially in the field of medical. They can be used for measurement of vital parameters, which include measurement of blood pressure, which includes measurement of heart rate, includes measurement of brain signal, and all other signals. So this wireless body area network having major applications in the area of medical and health sector. This term has been first used by Van Dam in 2001 and received the interest of several researchers. So this is what about history of wireless body area network. It was invented in 2001 by the scientist or a researcher named as Van Dam. Now, because of the development or advancement in the MEMS technology as well as the wireless communication technology, wireless body area network has undergone a technical boom in the last decade. We can use it for the applications like gaming application. We can use it in the form of wearable device, and by using the wearable device, we can perform many applications. Now, in case of wireless body area network, the communication in body sensor network is divided into two types. And the two types are, first is in-body communication and second is on-body communication. So let's look at what do you mean by in-body and on-body communication. In-body communication is the form of RF communication between the sensor node which are implemented inside the human body. And the frequency at which the communication takes place is defined by medical implantable communication services, which is also called as MICS, and the range of frequency is 402 to 405 megahertz. Now, the on-body communication is nothing but the type of RF communication which takes place between the variable sensor nodes. That means the variable devices which consist of biosensor comes under this category, whereas the sensors which are implemented inside the human body comes in the category of in-body communication. IMS or UWB, that is ultra wideband communication, can be used for on-body communication. The IMS band is basically used for the industrial, scientific and medical application. It is a license free band and having a range of 2.4 to 2.485 gigahertz. So many of the electronic applications operates on this band as it is a license free, and therefore anyone do not require a special permission or a special license to operate on this band. So the electronic equipments, which includes microwave oven, cordless phone, also operates on the same frequency. So we can use the same frequency for function of wireless body area network. Now let's have the look of the requirements of the wireless body area network. The first requirement is low power consumption. Definitely, as the sensors are placed inside the human body or when it is wear by the human being, then the power requirement should be less, because the less power requirement results into longer battery life, as the devices, that means the wearable devices, are battery operated. Also, the sensors which are placed inside the human body operates on the battery only. Therefore, it is very much important that the node should consume less power so that they can be use battery for a longer period of time. The second feature is nothing but the self-healing. Self-healing indicates that the device must have the capability to heal itself whenever any damage occurs. As they are placed inside the human body, so it is not every time possible to operate the human being again and again. Therefore, the node which are used in case of wireless body area network, or the sensors which are used in case of body area network, must have the property of the self-healing. Then the next property is nothing, or the next requirement is nothing but the quality of service. As the sensors deals, or we can say the communication deals with the biosignals, therefore, in case of medical field, the quality of service plays an important role. The sensors must provide a better quality of service, or we can say the wireless body area network must provide a better quality of service so that it is possible for the user to detect the proper information. The next is nothing but the interoperability. It is not always necessary that the sensors which are placed inside the human body or the wearable devices which are wear by the human being may have the same company or same vendor equipment outside the body. Therefore, it must be important that the sensors which are placed inside the human body must be operate with the equipment from the different manufacturer. Then the next type of requirement is deployment, and next is data aggregation, next is security. When we talk about the wireless communication, then security plays an important role. As the signals are dealt with the biosignals, or we can say as the network deals with the information transmission related to the vital parameters of the human being, therefore the security is considered as an important parameter, because in case of wireless communication, the attackers may perform attack, and because of that attack, it may possible that the attacker have an access to the network, because of which it may possible that the attacker may manipulate the user's data or may manipulate the signal which is transmitted over the air. Therefore, it is very much important to provide the security to the data so that no one else, or we can say the unauthorized person, do not get an ability to access the network. Next is nothing but low complexity, MAC, and the network layer. So In case of wireless body area network, the architecture is same as the OSI reference model architecture. Therefore, it is very much important to have the less complex MAC layer and less complex network layer in order to perform the data transfer across the network. The next type of requirement is nothing but the few false alarm. Sometime in case of biosensors, a threshold value is set. And sometime when the certain parameter increases or decreases beyond the certain value of the threshold, then it may possible that generates a false alarm. So in case of biosensors, the less false alarms are required. The next type of requirement is nothing but the low latency. As the signals are dealing with the human body, therefore, it is very much important that the delay should not occur while transmission and reception of the signal. The next requirement is nothing but the maximum required communication bandwidth. And next is maximum power supply current and communication setup. The communication setup should be less complex and it should be more economical from user point of view. Therefore, these are the certain requirements that require to fulfilled by the wireless body area network in order to perform an application in various fields. Now let's talk about the standard which is defined by IEEE for wireless body area network. When the computer wants to communicate with each other, the data get transmitted across the network. And therefore, some rules or we can say some parameter or some step or procedures are required to be defined by some standard, so that the data transmission and reception can be takes place in proper manner and communication can be takes place in a more effective way. Therefore, the IEEE defines a standard for all the kinds of network, irrespective of whether it is wireless network or whether it is wired network. IEEE defines certain standards so that the communication can take place in a proper manner. Therefore, in case of body area network also, IEEE defines a standard and that is called as IEEE 802.16 standard. The IEEE 802 has established a task group called as IEEE 802.15.6 for the standardization of wireless body area network. The IEEE 802.15.6 standard defines a medium access control layer that supports the several physical layers such as narrowband, ultra-wideband, and human body communication layer. So here, the MAC layer and the network layer along with the physical layer plays an important role in communication. The modulation used by wireless body area network includes DQPSK, DBPSK, and GMSK techniques are used. The proper selection of the physical layer or frequency band remains as one of the important issues in development of the wireless body area network, because the frequency band are required to be selected in a such a way that they can deal with the human body signals. And therefore, the physical layer which basically performs the task of transmission and reception of data, that means the selection of the frequency band is required to be done very carefully. The available frequency for wireless body area network are regulated by the communication authorities in the different countries. The medical implant communication services band is a licensed band used for the implant communication and has the same frequency range of 402 to 405 MHz in most of the country. So, in order to use the wireless body area network in case of medical and healthcare application, the medical implant communication service defines one band of frequency and that band having the same frequency range as the frequency range provided by 402 to 405 MHz. And this band is mostly common in most of the countries. And we require to perform the wireless body area communication on this band also. As it is a license-free band, therefore, it can be used for any of the application. The last frequency range is 2004 to 2483.5 MHz. So within this frequency range also we can perform or we can implement the wireless body area network. Now let's look at the architecture of wireless body area network. So basically the architecture is get divided into four different parts, and the parts are wireless body area network part. The second part is central control unit, which is represented by CCU. The next is wireless band communication, and next is a control center. So here also we from the diagram we come to know that the sensor nodes are nothing but the wireless band part. The central control unit is present, Then wireless communication takes place by using a access point and by using a internet, and then at the end center controller is present. Now let's discuss the function of these parts in detail. As we know, the wireless band is, or we can say the wireless body area network, is designed for the special purpose, and for that purpose the various sensors are used, which can autonomously connect with the various sensors and appliances located inside and outside of the human body. So by using these sensors, it is possible to detect the various signals from the human body, which consider as a biosignals, and that biosignals can be used for analyzing the patient health, for detecting the various diseases in the person, and for many more application. Basically, the architecture, as we just discussed, is get divided into four part. The first part is nothing but wireless body area network part. The wireless body area network part consists of several nodes. That means the various sensors which are placed either inside the human body or present on the human body. The nodes required to be cheap and low power consume node, because as they are placed sometime inside the human body, therefore they are required to be battery operated, and therefore in order to have the longer battery life, it is required that the node or the sensor should consume less power. All the sensors can be used for a continuous monitoring of the movement, vital parameters like heart rate, ECG, blood pressure, etc., and the surrounding environment. As the sensors are placed inside or on the human body, therefore they are basically used for the measurement of blood pressure, they are used for the measurement of heart rate and ECG and many other parameters which are related to the human body. They are vast monitoring system are used already based on the wired connection. Any wired connection in the monitoring system can be a problematic and could restrict the mobility of the user. Definitely, when the sensor are get connected to the wired communication medium, or if they transmit the information with the equipment which is having a wired connectivity, then that thing definitely restrict the mobility of the person. And to avoid that, the wireless body area network comes into the picture. So the wireless body area network can act as an effective solution, as we discussed it, because of which it is possible for the user to move anywhere inside the user premises that will not restrict the user's movement. So wireless band can act as a very effective solution in this area, especially in the healthcare system where a patient needs to be monitored continuously and requires mobility. So in certain cases, it is very much important, or it is required, that the continuous monitoring of the user needs to be takes place in a proper manner. And at the same time, there is no need to restrict the user's movement. So in that case, the wireless body area network can play an important role. The next section is nothing but the coordination node, where the entire sensor nodes will directly connected with the coordination node, which is called as central control unit, that is CCU. That means all the sensor nodes, or we can say all the sensors, provide their output to a one unit, and that unit is called as central control unit. Now the function of the central control unit is to receive the signals which are in the form of biosignals from the human body and transmit it to the further system, or transmit it to the further processing for monitoring of the human body activities. So when the central control unit transmits the signal for further processing, that unit or that system further monitors the human body. There is no such wireless technology is fixed for targeting wireless band. Most popular wireless technology used for the medical monitoring are wireless LAN network, then Wi-Fi network, GSM, 3G, 4G, then wireless PAN, which includes Bluetooth and Zigbee, and many more. That means the transmission of the user information, or transmission of the information from central control unit to the next part of the system, is takes place wirelessly by using any of the technique. There is no specific technique that required to be used for this transmission. We can use Bluetooth transmission if it is a short range. We can use a Zigbee transmission. We can use a GSM for transmission of the signal when the distance is much more larger, or else we can use the wireless LAN or Wi-Fi network for transmission of the signal. Wireless Medical Telemetry Services, which stands for WMTS, and Ultra Wideband are the another technologies that can be used for body monitoring of the user as they operate in the low power transmission system. the first requirement of wireless body area network is nothing but the low power consumption. And the two techniques, that is nothing but the ultra wideband communication and WMTS, satisfied this requirement. Therefore, instead of using Wi-Fi and wireless LAN, which consumes more power as compared to these two technology, we can use these two technology for transmission of the signal. Now, moving to the next section of the architecture is nothing but the wireless band communication, which acts as a gateway to transfer the information to the destination. So, after receiving the signals from central control unit, the signals are transmitted to the destination by using a gateway. A mobile node can be a gateway to a remote station to send a mobile message to a cellular network by using GSM, 3G and 4G. So, the process of, or we can say the task of transferring the information from central control unit to a gateway can be takes place with the help of gateway. The gateway can be in the form of mobile phone, which can be used for transmitting the SMS or MMS by using a GSM or by using a 3G, 4G network to a destination. A router or a PC can be a remote node to communicate via email or any other services by using the Ethernet. So, here we can also say that routers and PC can be considered as a node by using which we can perform the transmission of the signal. Now, the last section is nothing but the control unit or control center, which consists of end node devices such as mobile phone for message, PC for monitoring, and email and server for storing the information in the database. So the central unit, or we can say the control center, is basically responsible for storing of the information of the user so that it can be used in the future, or else it can be a system that is used for monitoring of the various parameters of the human body, or it can be simple a mobile phone which is used for the purpose of message. So in this way, the architecture of wireless band works, which basically consists of four parts. First part is nothing but the sensors which are placed inside or on the human body, and their function is to detect the various signals from the human body. The second part is nothing but the central control unit, that stands for CCU, which basically responsible for receiving the information from sensor and transmit it to the further system for further processing. The third part is nothing but the gateway, which can be a simple mobile phone and acts as a node for transmission of the signal from central control unit to the destination. The last part is nothing but the control center. Basically, it is a process, or we can say it may be a simple monitoring system which is used for monitoring the various parameters of the user body, or it can be a simple PC that is used for storing the user's information. Now, let's move on to the next topic, that is related to the wireless body area network applications. Similar to the other wireless network like wireless LAN, wireless MAN, then Wi-Fi, the wireless body area network is also used for the communication purpose. It is also used for transmission of signal from one place to another place. The signal can be in the form of data, it can be in the form of voice, audio, video, picture, or any other form of information that can be transmitted by using a radio interface. For this reason, the wireless band network has introduced a several number of innovative and effective applications. Broadly, the applications of the wireless body area network is get classified into two types. First one is the medical application and second is non-medical application. When we talk about the wireless body area network application, the most common use of wireless body area network is in the field of medical and health sector. So let's have first look of the medical applications related to the wireless body area network. As compared to other field, the wireless body area network find majority of the application in case of medical and health sector. The wireless band technology is improving the efficiency of doctor-patient activities such as a remote patient monitoring, timely health status, notification, emergency calling, etc. anytime at anywhere. So this basically provides a more flexible way of monitoring the patient, more flexible way of detecting the status of the health of the patient, and more effective way of providing the medicine to the patient, and that can be takes place at anywhere at any time. So this consider as a most important advantage of the wireless body area network, and because of that it finds most of the applications in case of healthcare and medical sector. Now let's talk about the certain applications where we can use this wireless body area network in case of medical. So the first application is nothing but remote healthcare monitoring. The wireless body area network can offer automatic medical services through a remote monitoring of the patient's vital organ. The sensors, in this case, the sensors are placed on the human body and they are capable of sending the status of the organ, or we can say status of the body organ, which includes body temperature, which includes heart rate, then blood pressure, ECG signals for monitoring the health activity. And also they are used for making the movement in order to monitor the patient's movement. Now these sensors can be of two type, as we know that the on the basis of the sensors, whether they are mounted inside the human body or outside the human body, the body area network itself get classified into two types. So there are two types of sensor: in-body sensors and on-body sensors. The on-body sensors are nothing but the wearable devices which can be used by the user for performing multiple tasks. The in-body sensors are implemented inside the human body in order to measure the vital parameters from the sensors. All the information can be monitored and stored in the form of control unit, and it is stored remotely. So by using this information which is stored remotely, it is possible for the doctor to check the status of the health of the patient or to check the status of various vital parameters of the patient. So remote health monitoring is possible by using a wireless body area network. The next form of application is nothing but assisted living. The wireless body area network has another exciting application in the medical and health sector services known as assisted living. Wearable medical sensors can be used at home to measure the psychological data of the patient's body and transmit or store them into the particular medical central server or control unit on the regular interval. So because of which it is possible for the doctor to check or to continuously monitor the patient health and to suggest the required changes in its lifestyle. So because of this, it is possible for the user to stay at home and get continuous support from the doctor instead of living inside the hospital. Now, in case of any emergency, the sensor implanted on the human body of the patient, which is present at home, can raise an alarm of urgent notification to the nearby medical center. So in this way, we can say that the wireless body area network can also be helpful in case of emergency conditions. Next is nothing but one of the most widely used application, that is nothing but telemedicine. The telemedicine is considered as a fascinating application of the wireless body area network, and it provides the healthcare services over a distance with the help of information and the communication technology. So by sending the users, or we can say by sending the patient information to the doctor by using a wireless body area network, it is possible for the doctor to monitor the behavior of the patient and to monitor the health status of the patient and accordingly suggest the medicine for the same. The wireless body area network technology can be integrated in the sector of telemedicine, like online video consultation with the doctors, then transmission of the medical reports and images, remote medical diagnostics, and many more. So with the help of these technology, it becomes possible for the user as well as the doctor to have a flexible So with the help of these type of technology, it is possible for the patient and doctor to have a flexible timing appointment. Now next is nothing but this wireless body area network technology helps the patient to get a treatment at a distance, where doctor can provide e-prescription by monitoring the patient's condition from anywhere. Now these are basically the applications which are related to the medical field. Now let's move on to the non-medical applications of wireless body area network. The first application is nothing but the sports. The wireless body area network consists of the sensor nodes which are placed on the human body. So these nodes are nothing but the wearable devices. So the wireless body area network enabled devices can be a wearable devices. It is very effective to monitor the psychological activities of the person, like the heart rate of the person, temperature, body temperature, then we can measure the respiration rate, we can measure the blood pressure, and we can measure the posture of any athlete in the sports. At the same time, the navigation, timer, distance can also be measured by using the various body area sensor network. The next type of application is nothing but in the field of military. So the wireless body area network can provide the number of opportunity to be used in the field of military. So in the battlefield, the wireless body area network can be used to communicate between the soldiers and send their location, or we can say send their activities like attacking, running, retreating and digging to the base commander. So with the help of this type of network, it is possible to provide a more secure communication, and also it is possible to detect and monitor the movement of the soldiers and to provide a required facilities to them. So we can use wireless body area network in military application by using a number of other services. The wireless body area sensors are also helpful to monitor the health condition of the soldier. It is also possible to monitor the location of the soldier as well as the temperature and the hydration level of the soldiers in the battlefield. Those sensors like a camera, GPS, monitoring sensors, RF can be implemented with the military uniforms. So in the any military application or in any military operation, wireless body area network can provide more accurate and more efficient connectivity and survivability of the soldier. Next is nothing but the lifestyle and entertainment. The wireless body area network plays a vital role in our day-to-day life. It enables some basic services like navigation support while walking, driving, exploring to a new city, etc. Then infant monitoring also can be achieved by using a wireless body area network. Wireless wearable music system, making video calls by using a big screen TVs, playback of audio and videos from the portable devices to a TV or audio system are some examples of the wireless body area network. Or else by using a wearable device, we can also play various games by using a wireless body area network. So we can say the wireless body area network is considered as an emerging technology which is expecting to have a great impact on our society as well as in the field of medical and non-medical sector. Continuation of the topic. Most specifically, the wireless body area network finds its variety of application in the field of medical. Also, the aim of this work was to offer a suitable and appropriate wireless technology in order to deploy a network. Several non-medical factors will also play a crucial role in the success of wireless body area network technology, which includes affordability, which includes legal and regulatory and ethical issues, and also includes the user friendliness, comfort and acceptance by the user. So depending upon these factors, the wireless body area network can play a very vital role, or we can say a wireless body area network can work as a most innovative and most emerging technology in today's day-to-day life. So I hope you understand this topic of wireless body area network, which plays a vital role in the medical and health sector. At the same time, we can use it for other applications also. So I hope you understand this topic. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.